All right, I want to welcome the Gospel Gangstaz and Royalty to the Testimony Tube, and we just want to get to know a little bit about the Gospel Gangstaz. I remember hearing your name and in the beginning when I heard about gospel rap, and I'm like, Gospel Gangstaz? You know, and that's probably how other people see it, you know, until you hear the music, until I got into the gospel rap and understand, you know, you're there for the Lord and, you know, the work that you're doing, it's a ministry. And can you kind of tell me your name and how it came about?
I'm Solo. They call me the coach from the legendary Gospel Gangstaz.
Mm-hmm. I'm Chille Baby from the legendary Gospel Gangstaz.
Okay.
And then we got Royalty.
Testimony, Campaign.
All right.
Campaign Records, Campaign Ministry, Campaign Films, Campaign Nonprofit.
Campaign Movies, Campaign Magazine.
Wow.
The 80s is the new beginning, but how it all came about was, you know, the conversion of me and our brother TikTok, you know, ex Crips and Bloods, who was, you know, they had been delivered from the streets, from a high-level gang warfare. Just, we was a part of the neighborhood. We was a part of the problem at this time. And Chille Baby was part of the problem, too. He was, at that time, he was a drug dealer. This is where we came from. You know, this was our upbringing. This was the culture we embraced as kids. And we grew up in this for years. And in the midst of it, you know, we became, like, so the mind, so as the Bible says, so a man thinketh, so he is. Mm-hmm. We believe this was Crip. We was willing to kill or die for that, because we believe this Crip do or die, mm-hmm. you know, period. Crip or cry, you know, and we believed it until losing our lives. I mean, people have been, you know, we've seen so many people from our generation, from our close peers, not just stories we heard. I mean, people that we've had to personally bury and mm-hmm. call their mothers and tell them that your son is dead.
Wow.
And, you know, we have friends that sold drugs, but that spirit turned on them and they became their own best customers,
mm-hmm.
to where they're addicts. I have friends that have lost their minds from drugs and from bad drugs and things like that. I mean, we've seen so many different situations, from friends go to jail to where they go to jail, and people don't hear about people going to jail, getting raped in jail, stabbed up in jail, losing an eye in jail. I mean, it's a very
big thing.
People
don't hear, a lot of people don't hear about
that. The devil's an evil creature.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I mean, when you see it on TV, you know, something always different when you see it on TV than when you're in the midst of it.
Right.
You know, like a lot of people see Crips and Bloods in California on TV, but when you live in the midst of it, it's mm-hmm. a totally different story.
Wow.
You feel what I'm saying? It's more, actually more extensive than TV.
And intense. Yeah.
And intense.
If you're not in that lifestyle, you look off, you know, you stand afar and you can see, ooh, they over there doing that. When you in the mix of it, you are, like my mother, you know, there was times I had to come home as a kid and tell my mother, Mama, I may have to move, I have to leave.
Wow.
She's like, why? And
you
I show her a piece,
because...
I show her the newspaper. We did this, you know,
wow.
And this, we shot a party up and three people shot, you
so
know.
So we might can't live here, Mama, no more,
wow.
because we did our
it's
thing.
It's in the paper,
it's
I don't know if they
it's certain neighborhood. It's certain neighborhoods by being Crips, like, we couldn't even move. Like, if my mama wanted to move to this neighborhood, she can't move to that neighborhood.
Right.
Because
get
of
the
me.
Whole house, kid.
No way. I'm not going to, you know, everybody in my house would die or something. So,
wow.
You know what I'm saying? Like, the gangbanging lifestyle is very explicit. It's very wild.
Yeah.
It's very, I wouldn't admonish nobody. A lot of these kids now, that's their goal, to be a gangster. That's their goal, to be
mm-hmm.
a hustler.
They think
it's glorified.
Cool.
It's nothing to
somebody who's never been involved with it, really, would try to glorify it. Because, like, I have a son. It's no, I would almost give my life before I let him gangbang.
Mm-hmm.
Because I know that what he would be doing, giving his
right.
life. He would throw his life away. And I'd rather be a sacrifice for him before he did it. So if I wouldn't do it for my own, you feel, I wouldn't admonish. I wouldn't, and I feel bad for all the other people that I've influenced to get in the game.
Right.
It's people who haven't turned around that I brought to the game.
Wow.
And they still off in the wayward way. And, you know, I got born again. You know, I got shot. You know what I mean? And matter of fact.
Is that your turning point there?
That was the genesis of the turning point.
Okay.
That was just the seed because, you know, us as men, we're very rebellious, you know.
Right.
I got to, well, I didn't get into a situation, Chille Baby. Just show you that my love for Chille Baby been since we always, like, David and Jonathan, we got that relationship.
Wow.
And, we was gangbanging. He was, you know, stayed in the hot spot, stayed in the dope house. He called me up like 2 a.m.
because
I just got jumped. Cause I'm ready to. I gotta go. It's gonna happen right now. We gotta do this. And me being just too witty. I know people out there understand the two witties, but I was just too witty. You know what I mean, Royalty?
Mm-hmm.
I'm hopping fresh up out. You know, I'm in sin with a woman. I hop fresh out, throwing some gear. I'm on my way. Push right over there to get murdered. You feel me? I went
right.
over there and we walked into the alley where the altercation cracked. And anybody from, you ain't got, if you really from the streets, you know, once y'all get into a fist fight or something, somebody, everybody finna go get their guns waiting for right. the after effect.
Mm-hmm.
We walked up on the after effect with no pistols, and they got the busting, and I caught his 20-20 gauge by buckshot splattered me. You know, we didn't have pistols, so you know,
at everybody when, flee you know, at that point.
We broke. Mm-hmm. You know, all I could do is pray, Lord, don't let me die in this alley.
Right.
You know, and my mother was a praying warrior. You know, she used to pray when we was gangbanging. She used to always. I used to have my homeboys come over. We'd be like have meetings and. You know, setting up missions and things, robberies, whatever.
Yeah,
my mother would be upstairs praying in the spirit. Well, they'd be like, "Hey, your mother like, African? What's your mother doing?"
Wow.
She'd be upstairs praying in tongues, just binding the devil because she knew something. It's an evil congregation going on.
Wow. Right?
So she'd just be binding it, running them spirits out. The homies be like, "Man, I'm gonna go, man. Your mama crazy."
Wow.
Your mama crazy.
The power of praying, mama.
But she prayed me into the kingdom. Where you know the spirit of the Lord began to convict me, what the spirit of Yah began to convict me,
mm-hmm.
and just had me where I couldn't even sleep at night, and I
wow.
couldn't sin with a woman or nothing. I mean, it was like I would feel, man, I'm gonna go to sleep and wake up with my eyes in the lake of fire.
Wow.
And I just said, well, Father, you convicted me. I can't sin right. I can't do nothing. I mean, I don't even have these desires no more. You have to change me. You have to help me. I can't do it alone. And I remember just calling out to God, and I was so angry because I was failing myself. I was like, I can't do it right. I can't, like Paul, wretched man
right
I am.
Right.
I can't find the right way. I began to cry, and that's when I knew it was hard. I felt the Father was changing that heart of stone into a heart of flesh again. Because I remember it had been years since I had never even cried, just from standing in front of bodies at caskets and can't even cry, just whatever. Just put together a retaliation squad and let's just go.
Wow.
Put it down. I mean, I felt my tears had dried up, but the Father began to restore that, and I began to just repent. I remember crying and repenting all night for all the things, every woman that I had degraded and done wrong to, everybody I had hurt. And, you know, I used to do robberies. I mean, I used to run into people that, man, you don't remember him? Nope, you robbed him.
Wow. I mean, we sitting up there, him sitting like, up there, be like, remember y'all robbed him?
And
y'all,
like,
and we sitting up there like,
for real?
We don't even remember.
Yeah, I don't remember these things.
I mean, that's how, what I'm saying is that just shows you how the devil trick you. Like, you know, he give you he trick you.
Mm-hmm.
And have you doing stuff you don't even remember.
Wow.
That shows you that goes to show you right there that you can be led by a different spirit.
Oh yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? A lot of people don't really believe it. You could be driven. That's what the devil do. The Holy Spirit leads, the devil drives.
That was basically how the enemy had us programmed. I would wake up and like I would go to sleep at night and I would buy 2 night trains, or I would buy a 40-ounce and a night train. We call it that Crip juice.
Okay.
You drink half of the 40, then pour the night train in it. And you know, shake it up and throw it in the freezer for the morning so you can wake up on the low one. Meaning that's breakfast. How about that? That's we get up with 40.
6 a.m. We up.
A sock
40,
full of dope.
Four at 7 o'clock.
Head to the dope spot.
I done drunk me a fresh 8-ball. Before it's even 7
early
o'clock. By the time 6:30 hit, my khakis is creased. I'm ready for war and I done drunk me a 40. That's how the devil had us so driven.
Program.
But to go to show you how the Father does it, how Yahweh does it, he saves him, bring him back to the block, to me. So see, a lot of people like out there that's thinking like, you know, these people is crazy. Nah, man, if you what God you serve? What Yahweh you serve? Who you serve then? You supposed to have a spirit of love, peace, and sound mind. You can go to anybody with authority from him and tell them about it. You know, and he used to come to the block, get me, drive around the corner, minister to me, and drop me back off. You know, so it's like when you minister to somebody, you love somebody, give them the Father. Give them Yahweh, give them Elohim. You know what I'm saying? If you love them so much. So he loved
the
world,
and
he gave his only begotten Son.
Right.
And that's the motivation behind the Gospel Gangstaz ministry.
Right.
It's nothing really a gangster could tell me, really.
Right.
Honestly, it's nothing you can tell me because I did everything on the streets except die.
Right.
Period. So that's it. You know, you can't influence me that this is, I mean, now there is like people used to say, we used to say crime pays.
Mm-hmm.
You can get paid, but crime costs as well.
Mm-hmm.
Because you can get paid. I got a lot of people make money, but guess what? I got a lot of people doing a lot of time behind the money they made.
Mm-hmm.
And it ain't worth it.
Life and everything.
And not only that, what would a man, when you sell me everything you can gain from the streets, I could tell you, what will a man exchange?
Right.
I mean, cause
for his own
to
soul,
keep it real,
you feel me?
What would you offer
in exchange for your soul?
For one dude that got $1 million in the dope game, I could show him 20 of them that have lost and got 20 years in the pen.
Exactly.
So, I mean, it just don't, add up at the end of the day.
And how the feds got the gang tapped now, it's not even worth it now. I mean, and not only that, you living a life apart from the Heavenly Father, which you weren't designed to do. You feel me? And, you know, it's almost like a plant. When you sever that plant from its root, it's dying. Death is taking place. It may take some time. It look green, but it's finna wither away because it's separated from its life source. Mm-hmm. And that's what happens when we're separated from the Father. We're separated from our life source because so we can't expect ourselves to continue to flourish and grow properly. We're going to start to wither. If nothing else, your spirit, you wonder why people walk around so angry and bitter.
Right.
So contentious and just not happy and so lustful. I mean, these are things that come from not being satisfied. Not, you know, that's that unsatisfaction, that's that void that's in your heart. You're searching for that feeling. And the only person who can fill that void is the Heavenly Father.
You know, so what would you tell, like, so if somebody's watching this video and they're in the a gang or something like that and they want to get out, what would be your solution? How do you think they should go about it? In prayer.
Get out.
Just get out.
I would tell them to get out. I mean, if that's what your mind says, get out, whatever.
You know, there's consequences.
I mean, on the real, I'm going to keep it real. This is raw and uncapped. Whatever it takes to get out. If that means you going back through the court off process, that means getting jumped out. You was bold enough to get jumped in the devilish gang.
Right.
Go back and take your beating and get out if you that serious.
Right.
Don't run and hide. You know, face them. Let them know, I ain't with this no more.
Right.
And honestly, how gangs is today, it ain't like it used to be. If you don't want to be from a neighborhood these days, they'll let you go. Yeah. They don't want a non-affiliate anyway.
All right.
You end up being a snitch. With the business.
You had to really be changed for real. Because it used to have dudes that would come check on you just to see if you really
In church. Because if you ain't in church, they're
going to come knock you down. They're going to lay you out. Because
the thing is, you might know too much.
Right,
you know
right.
about murders. You know about drug houses. You know about gang. You know about too much. And then you leave and we don't know if you're an informant. We don't know.
Right.
It's better to have that eliminated. That's an unturned stone as far as they're concerned.
And plus, you'll never know. Look, any gangster out there, any hustler, you'll never really know yourself until you know Yahweh himself. You would never really know yourself because the you think that you're not really you. Because once you start getting with him, you'll find out who the really you is, for real.
You begin to build character and personality. People say, I'm a little half-dead. I'm a little skull. I'm killer. I'm stone. I mean, I'm demon. They confess these things on themselves.
Mm.
And before you know it, they walk
life
in it.
Life and death is in the power of the tongue.
It's like when I was young, I always share this with my boys. We was talking about this today, how when I was young, before I had that spirit had took over me, I used to put the mask on. Like, there was a time, and I know every OG been through this, because it's a day when you was a youngster, you feel me? And you wanting to be that G. And I used to practice my mean mug. I used to practice, what's up, cuz? I used to practice I used to look in the mirror, what's up, cuz? I used to practice banging on people. I used to practice giving up the hood. I used to practice everything. I would practice fighting. I would practice, and I would put the mask on. I'm evil, cuz. You know, and after so long, I couldn't take that mask off. It was really me. I began to believe it. I believed that lie.
Wow.
And when I thought it, I would just say, what's up, cuz? I'm a killer. And once I keep speaking these things, before you know it, it's like, I'll kill him. I will kill. Mm-hmm. I am a killer. And I believed it. Don't let him say nothing to you. Nigga, you a killer. Mm-hmm. Blow that nigga head off if he say something. You feel? And before you know it, you acting it out. You move. It all start with a thought.
Right.
But before, then I couldn't take that mask off no more. I mean, my mama asked, called me. I'm like, what's happening, cuz? Boy, don't call me no cuz. You know what I mean, mama. No, I don't know what you mean. I'm your mother.
Because
it was just in my heart so bad to where it was just, it was me at that point.
I was rolling in the car, me and my daughter, and I was telling her, like, I can't believe I did some of the stuff I did. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like, since we was Crips, we used to do stupid stuff. Like, I wouldn't even stop at a red light. Because the light was red.
Red can't stop.
I would take that chance flying through the red light, not knowing not knowing if a car going to smash into me, not knowing.
Or either make a right. Anything. We finna turn right. We finna do anything to stop at this red
light. Yeah, I'm not stopping at this red light. Not. Because the devil have me so tricked.
And you know, even in the language you take, we built our lives around this mentality, this culture. Where we changed our words, we wouldn't use C word, we wouldn't use B words. Every B word would be replaced with a C.
Instead of saying bus, we'll say cuss.
You know what I'm saying?
Instead of saying
believe, we'll say C-lead.
Because the B represent the blood gang. C represents the Crip.
Okay, okay.
And that was a form of disrespect.
So when you see Bloods, instead like of saying cup, Bloods will say buck.
Or like, see, like you got say that coffee, that camera, they'll say, turn on the Bammer.
Wow.
Blood, me, you got some bookies, Blood? You know what I'm saying?
You got some bookies, maybe some cookies.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, my goodness.
Some ice cream, so it's Big all, back and Big Boo. You know, and we and out of that's they that's their disrespect to the sea. Like, we don't use C words like Big back and Big Boo, Blood. That, instead of saying kick back and see cool, cuz. Feel me? It's two different cultures and two different languages. And
but we both, go, now look, but we both go to jail the same.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's the same, the same outcome, the same demise.
We just live in two different sets. And that's the big thing right there. See, that's how the devil run it
off. And what we go back to these young brothers and let them know is that you're selling your soul for a jelly roll. Because with gangbanging, there's no pension, there's no retirement, there's no benefits, there's no dental plan, there's nothing.
Right.
You only thing you can do is bring your mother heartache and pain. Because eventually she's going to be called saying you in jail or the ultimate call. We need you to come identify this John Doe tag on this boy toe.
Man, I got a,
I mean, he's dead.
Man,
he listen, down at
we got
this,
we got a little homie that's, and we got a little homie that's doing 50 years right now. Mm-hmm.
50. I got a homie got 106 years. How about that? I mean, it's so many. That's what I'm saying. It's ridiculous how many young brothers, I mean, Latinos, Hispanic, it doesn't matter because sin don't have a face. That the enemy is just destroying the lives of a lot of these brothers that's being took off the street. That's what our ministries is based around, saving his brothers. You know what I mean? Saving the young people,
you know,
because if it wasn't for his grace, I could have been there.
I mean, I'll be doing the same thing.
Every day I lived a life of crime. You feel me? And everything that I've done through the course of my life, if I was to be, I thank the Father for forgiveness and for repentance. Because if I was to be judged according to man, like that's why David said, Father, I'd rather fall in your hands than the hands of man. Because if I was judged, if I was judged by man, then I probably, I would have no reason to be released to the streets.
I'd probably be hung in the morning.
Wow.
That's how, that's how, that's how.